Ma'am, thanks for joining us from Pampanga.
Hi, Angelo.
How are you?
All good.
For today's show and tell, what kind of dish do you have for us?
I have some puro here with me. So this is burong isda. It's called gurami, the small fish, similar to tilapia.
So how do you do that buro?
Well, this buro kasi is fermented for about 10 days. Sabi nga nila, when you make buro, the longer the better. But I think the shortest possible time is around a week. So it's just layered fermented rice and fish with lots of salt. And then put it in a container, sealed one. You'll see that it will become mushy and the bones of the fish will melt. That's your indicator that you can saute it already with ginger, onions, and tomatoes.
How do you usually eat it?
You eat it with mostaza, mustard leaf, with boiled ampalaya or talong, of course with grilled meats or grilled fish.
So it's like a condiment?
It's a condiment, actually.
Okay, and you can turn other stuff into buro also, not just that kind of fish, right?
Oh, definitely. You can buro mangga, you can buro talangka. Filipinos love to make buro, even at chara. So talagang we're really into something like this.
And do you have any special memory growing up with buro?
Buro kasi, this is a staple in our family table. So, I mean, Kapampangans would talagang eat with buro on a typical day. So, it's a common staple in our family. Just like achara, parang we cannot live without it pag may grill, pag may fiesta or handaan. It's always there.
Thank you very much for introducing us to buro, Jam.
Thanks, Angelo.
Be safe.
Bye.